welcome to People's Dispatch. Today we are at the May Day rally in New Delhi, India, where hundreds of workers have gathered to celebrate the occasion. We are joined by Comrade A.R. Sindhu, who is the General Secretary of All India Association of Anganwadi Workers and Helpers. Thank you, Comrade, for joining us. So can you first tell us about the importance and significance of May Day in India for the workers of India?
This year on May Day, we are here after continuous and consistent struggles against these neoliberal policies of this regime, and particularly after this Modi government came to power, there was unprecedented attack on the workers' rights, and even the hard-earned rights of the 8-hour working hours and minimum wages, all were not only it was not implemented, but it was in a planned manner, he was taking away all those things by the labor law amendments. And when the fifth day onwards of his regime, he started amending the labor laws. And even just before the declaration of the elections also, there was an effort to even though reduce the minimum wages, which was earlier decided. So this was a continuous attack, and at the same time it was a continuous struggles by the working class, led by the trade union movement in India and CITU. So here you can see that this movement, it was to some extent, and we were able to stall this the changes in labor laws. They cannot make the labor codes into existence. And then the privatization of the public sector, that was not, we didn't allow it to happen. And also, there was an upsurge of the peasant movement, which was strongly supported and guided by the trade union movement. And that was, and though this, there was a worker peasant joined programs and agitation, including the 9th August, the Jail Bharo program of the both the working class and trade unions together, peasant organizations together, and also a biggest ever rally of the peasantry and working class together in Delhi. And this was a period where we had the biggest ever strike for 48 hours, the 8-9 January strike. And this movement, it was able to even bring in all the other movements against the oppression, like the Dalit movements, then the women's movement, or the movements of Adivasis, and even the other minorities and various sections. We brought it into a platform, and all those strings against these policies. So the issue-based struggles have converged into the struggles against these policies. And this is having, this is during the elections, this May Day is there. So this was, we were able to make the burning issues of the working people of the country into the main agenda of these elections as well. Like the minimum wages, social security and pension, and also the minimum support price and the this loan waiver of the peasantry. These were the issues even today in these elections. And these elections, we are sure that the people of the country will be throwing away this Modi regime. And even after the elections also, we are sure that there won't be any such government, because the main opposition parties are also not so different from these policies. The same policies they are also pursuing. But this struggle will be continuing, and it's going to aggravate, the attack is going to aggravate in the background of the world systemic crisis of capitalism, and in the world over the working class resistance is coming up. So there will be having in solidarity and in coordination with the world trade union movement and the working class movement, there will be struggle against the policies with the putting forward the alternatives of the people. So in the coming days, and with the background of all these struggles, and whichever government will come to power after the elections, there will be an upsurge of the working class movement with the active participation of the peasant movement, and it will definitely in the coming days, this will be in decisive role in deciding the issues before the people and the policies of the government also.
Can you also talk a bit more about the struggles faced by Anganwadi workers in particular and the struggles led by them to overcome these issues?
The struggles by the Anganwadi workers and also the scheme workers, this was in its peak in the last few years, and this was visible, and this was led by the women, and this directly the workers, Anganwadi workers, Asha workers, the midday meal workers, and the other government workers in the government schemes. This was directly they got many benefits, but this was having an more a social and political impact in the society and also in the movements also, because this has given tremendous confidence to the working class movement, and also because they are all over the country, even in the rural areas, so it is like having an indirect impact in the peasant movement also, to give them confidence and bring them back to the struggles from going into suicides and all. So this is, I think that this is also a very positive feature, and is the mainstream trade union, led by the mainstream trade union movement, and we had during this period the first ever joint strike of the scheme workers on 17th of January 2018, and that had a participation of around more than 50 lakh actively on the roads. So these are all the things which mobilize the other sections also under the leadership of the trade union movement.
Thank you, comrade, for joining us today. Thank you for watching People's Dispatch.